Welcome to a lesson on solving two-step linear inequalities in one variable. The goals are to solve two-step linear inequalities as well as express the solutions as an inequality, a graph, and using interval notation. So here's a review of the three ways that we'll express the solutions. Here are some examples of inequality notation. Here's the same interval graph on the number line, and here's the same interval expressed using interval notation. If needed, you may want to pause the video here and review these three ways to express the solution of an inequality. Now, the steps to solve a linear inequality in one variable are the same if we were solving a linear equation, except if we multiply or divide by a negative when isolating the variable, we must reverse the inequality symbol. Looking at the inequality, negative 2 is less than 4. Notice if we divided both sides by negative 2, the left side would be positive 1, the right side would be negative 2, and then for this inequality to be true, we would have to reverse this inequality. So instead of less than, it would be greater than. 1 is greater than negative 2, which is true. So we need to be sure to keep this rule in mind when solving our inequalities. Here we have 3x plus 4 is greater than or equal to 10. So to isolate x on the left side, we would start by undoing this addition by subtracting 4 on both sides. This would be 0, so we have 3x is greater than or equal to 10 minus 4 is equal to 6. And since 3x means 3 times x, to isolate x, we'll have to divide both sides by 3. Now we're dividing by a positive, so we do not reverse the inequality symbol. This would be 1x, or just x, greater than or equal to positive 2. So here's our solution as an inequality. And now we'll go ahead and graph this interval on the number line. So if this is 0, let's go ahead and call this 2. X is greater than or equal to 2, and since 2 is in this interval, we make a closed point on 2, and then for values greater than 2, we'd have an arrow to the right approaching positive infinity. Now the reason I like to put this in here is it makes the transition to interval notation very straightforward. Meaning using interval notation, we'll have the interval from 2 to infinity. It includes 2, so we have a square bracket to the left of 2, and then we have a rounded parenthesis for positive infinity. We always use a rounded parenthesis for positive or negative infinity. Looking at our second example, we have negative 2x minus 1 is greater than 9. So we'll start by undoing this subtraction. So we'll add 1 to both sides. This would be 0. So we have negative 2x is greater than 9 plus 1 is 10. And now to solve for x, we have to divide both sides by negative 2. And since we're dividing by a negative, we do have to reverse the inequality symbol. So this will be 1x, or just x. And then instead of greater than, it's going to be less than. 10 divided by negative 2 is equal to negative 5. So here's our solution as an inequality. Notice how we did reverse the inequality symbol because we divided both sides by negative 2. And now we'll go ahead and graph this interval. So if this is 0, let's call this negative 5. This interval does not include negative 5. So now we have an open point on negative 5. And then for values less than negative 5, we have an arrow to the left, this time approaching negative infinity. So using interval notation, we'll have negative infinity and then negative 5. It doesn't include negative 5, so we have a rounded parenthesis here as well as here. Let's take a look at two more examples. Notice here these examples have the variable on the right side, but we'll follow the same steps, but now we'll just isolate x on the right. So to undo the subtraction, we'll add 2 to both sides. This would be 0, so we have 12 greater than or equal to, this is negative 3x. And now to solve for x, we have to divide both sides by negative 3. Again, we're dividing by a negative, so we're going to reverse the inequality symbol. So here we'll have negative 4, and instead of greater than or equal to, we'll have less than or equal to x. Now this is the solution expressed as an inequality, but we can go ahead and reverse the order here. This is equivalent to x is greater than or equal to negative 4. Notice how in both cases the inequality symbol is pointing toward the negative 4 and it's open toward the x. Let's go ahead and leave our answer in this form here. And now we'll graph this. X is greater than or equal to negative 4. Let's call this 0. Let's call this negative 4. Negative 4 is in this interval, so we have a closed point on negative 4. And then for numbers greater than negative 4, we have an arrow to the right, approaching positive infinity. So using interval notation, we have the interval from negative 4 to infinity. It includes negative 4, or we say it's closed on negative 4, so we use a square bracket here and a rounded parenthesis here. Okay, let's take a look at our last example. We want to isolate the x on the right side, so we need to subtract 12 on both sides. This is going to be negative 20 is greater than, this would be 0, so we're left with 5x on the right. And now to solve for x, we'll divide by 5 on both sides. Here we're dividing by a positive 5, so we're not going to reverse the inequality. So we have negative 4 is greater than x, but again it's more common to reverse the order here. Notice how the inequality symbol is pointing toward the x and open toward the negative 4, so we can rewrite this as x is less than negative 4. Let's go ahead and graph this. Negative 4 is not less than negative 4, so negative 4 is not in the interval. So we have an open point on negative 4. Then for values less than negative 4, we have an arrow to the left, approaching negative infinity. So using interval notation, we have negative infinity, we have a negative 4. It does not include negative 4, so we use a rounded parenthesis. And that's going to do it for this lesson.